Hey guys, it's Vishali. Well, I am at a very empty Stamford Bridge. Now, if you ever wondered what Stamford Bridge looks like after a game when everyone's gone home, and actually most of the staff have gone home, the players have all gone home, this is basically it. It's an eerie silence, but very peaceful. I'm nearly done with my work after this game between Chelsea and Bournemouth. Chelsea won it 1-0, really narrow win. But in today's vlog, I want to focus in on Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Now, I've spoken about him quite a few times this season because he is impressing. And today, he was very impressive against Bournemouth. Now, he started in a more advanced role. So he actually started, I think it was on the right of the forward line. And it's interesting because he is a midfielder. But this season, he has shown so much improvement under Maurizio Sarri. And, you know, it's not just the fact that he's creating goals, creating chances, which you'd expect from him as a midfielder. He's also improved in terms of his defensive work. And that's really what Sarri has been asking for from him, because with such an attack-minded formation, you need all your players, whether or not they're creative or more defensive, to basically work as a unit and defend. He has improved in that aspect, but today we saw just how impressive he can be in a more advanced role. I went to the press conference afterwards, and Gianfranco Zola, who took the press conference to Sir Maurizio Sarri, he was praising Ruben Loftus-Cheek, and he actually said that he's come off a long way since the beginning of the season. He said he sacrificed a lot on the pitch for Chelsea, and you know, that's why he's playing more and more. And that's a good sign for him and for Chelsea fans, because they love him. I mean, every time he plays on the pitch, they're always chanting his name. They really want to see a Chelsea Academy graduate basically break through into the first team. There haven't been that many over the years, but I do think he's got a really good chance of breaking through into the team. My quick thoughts on the next round for Chelsea. They're playing Tottenham away at Wembley. Oh, I can't wait for that game, because these games between Tottenham and Chelsea in the last couple of years have been absolutely fantastic. And who can forget that 3-1 win for Spurs at Wembley in the Premier League, the game that ended Chelsea's unbeaten run. Well, they're playing them again in the semi-finals. Zola admitted it's not an easy game, but he did say that a lot of the Chelsea players were hurt by the way that they were completely humiliated. Let's not lie about it against Spurs, and they'll be out for revenge. It'll be an interesting game, but it's going to be a tough one. And of course, even if Chelsea get through to the final, you'd assume that City will be there. So it's not going to be an easy game for them, an easy draw rather. But I think it's going to be an interesting end to the League Cup games. I'll be back on Saturday from Stamford Bridge. Yes, you've guessed it. I'm back here on Saturday as Chelsea take on Leicester in the Premier League.